Well, what do you get when you have yourself a set? Well, you gotta have yourself some fresh new pay dirt in the form of new Hot Wheels releases. And that's basically what we're gonna do today. We got ourselves one last bit of unboxing. 5 straight episodes worth of this stuff. But this will be the last, I can tell you that for sure. Because we're going to take a lot of these sets and put them into action. But first, what we're going to do here is unbox this final set, which is part of the action series known as the Vertical 8 Jump. Now, as you can basically see, that's its size supposedly when completed. This is a newer set, as you can see from this piece. And moreover, it does come with its own yellow time tracker. It seems quite common that yellow time trackers are going to be appearing in lots of sets, or in lots of packs, so to speak. And then, of course, we basically have all this to work with. This is about 20 cars worth, both old and new releases. So, let's get into the action. Get this guy unboxed, assembled, and all this out of the bag. And here it is, in its full glory. Well, just look at this thing and how tall it is. Man, knowing in person, the results are quite a bit different than what you might expect from the very get-go, the packaging and whatnot. And well, these are all the models that I plan on using. Plenty of cars, some motorcycles, but it does seem that I got a good variety here to work with. So, you're going on with me, and we're gonna go and explore the two unique possibilities that are within this layout. Thanks to this switch right here, it does seem we got plenty of things that we can do here. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. So I guess what we'll do first is have it aligned like this. So this way it'll go through this little figure eight that we got here, which lands into this. Yeah, so what do you say we try this out? I'm gonna get started with a buzz bomb that I basically got. It's a bit of a slightly newer recast as opposed to the other one that I had some time ago. So, let's try this out. Well, that wasn't so climactic. Oh! That didn't work so well. Well, all fixed now. I don't know why the wings broke off, but oh, jeez. Well, I guess we'll have to do without the wings. Bye-bye. I don't know how they keep breaking off like that, but let's try this again without the wings. Okay. Well, right off the bat, wingless buzz bomb manages to make it into the cup. First time there. Everything else didn't count. Next is a new for 2023 model, the 72 Corvette Stingray convertible. All right, here we go. Oh! Flobbed around there, but got pretty close. Oh! Flung out of the curve. One more time. I guess this wasn't its day. Now here we go, one of the motorcycle models that I got, Honda CB750 Cafe, which I seriously doubt is gonna work, so that's all folks, at least for this. Next up we have the Green Speed Fiat 500E. Yeah. Seems quite a bit different from the original Fiat 500 that I've had for some time, but let's give it a go. Oh, jeez. That can't end too good. Oh, boy. Well, I guess if there's one thing I could probably note here, look how high profile this guy is. Keeps rimming, well, kind of flying down into here. Technically fits, but just keeps flying off here. So I guess that pretty much calls it. Here we go. This is a newer version of Bedlam, which I've had before. But this was a yellow version that I've had years ago. Now, here comes a dark maroon variation, which I'm hoping does good here. It's a really good model on the track. All right, there you go. Right off the bat. And here comes another 2023 model, the Audi 90 Quattro. Ooh, yeah. Nice, smooth feeling. I got a good vibe here, and I got a good feeling might actually do good. Oh! Stops a little short, basically. But let's give it another go. Oh! Kind of the same thing here, but one more time. Kind of seemed like it would actually do good, but I guess not today. Next model here is known as Split Vision. Surely you might remember this. Yeah, same color, same name. Hopefully it brings a few flashbacks to you, maybe it doesn't, but this model is now back in my collection. And well, I guess for this fresher version of the original Split Vision I had, it does a great job. Now, Ducati Desert X is up next. Basically an off-road motorbike, as you can see here. Off-road tires and whatnot. But much like the Honda Cafe, I don't suppose it'll work. So we'll just set these guys off to the side. Although actually, what would be better? Oh! Didn't really stay upright there though. Kind of surprised. Went down without even toppling over. Next is the Porsche Cayman S. And I'm sure that the Cayman S is going to do a pretty fine job, like these other three that you see here. So, here we go. Porsche, it's your time to shine. Oh, not good. Woo, yeah. Excellent work. Surf and School Bus. Surely you might remember a brown version appearing in Hot Wheels Hilarity at some point. Or maybe you don't. Now, here comes an all-new version from the Gold Coast. Basically. Here we go. Oh. Not that good, but pretty close. Didn't get out properly. One more time. That wasn't so good either. Now here we go with Ultra Rage. Now, I've had this model before as well. That was a yellow and orange version, but now here we go with the plain red version. Now this model is also really good on the track, much like a few others I've done. Oh, didn't really get out of the curve properly. Second time. And there you go, second time is a charm. I'm sure happy to have this guy in my collection, as with a lot of others. 2017 Camaro ZL1, which I hope does a good job on the track too. But it's a Camaro, so I guess it's bound to have a few problems. But let's find out what it does here. Went upside down. And well, I guess that's a pretty good sign there. Next up is the Mustang NHRA Funny Car, which, of course, you probably remember when I had a Dodge Neon Funny Car. Well, this one, okay, so it looks like this Funny Car has a body that's fused together, so looks like you can't take it apart like the other ones. Well, that didn't work too good there. Second time. And, well, I guess we'll try backwards. Forwards again, just for good measure. Not so good there. And now we're going down to the last tier of models. Straight Pipes is coming up first. It's kind kind of nice how we're getting some good success with this whole setup here. Okay, that one didn't turn out so good there. And one more time. Okay. Got pretty close, but not quite enough for a victory cigar. Next model we have here is known as Shell Shock, which I am positive is going to make a good success here. And I'm certain this is really nice looking. I mean, that design's one thing, but let's see how it does functionality-wise. Stopped a little short, so... Haha! Excellent. Power Sander is up next, but this one is more gold as opposed to the pretty unique cyan coloring of the last version of Power Sander that I had. So, let's see how it does in this setup. Ooh. That wasn't too good. And, well, let's see how one more time does it. Yeah, this one's not a great model by all means. Here we go. This is Hypertruck. Essentially, like if you took the body design of Reverb and added a bedding to the back end of it, then well, this is what you get out of it. So, how does it work in this layout? Well, does a great job. Right on its first chance, too. Here's another 2023 model, the Baja Bison TS, which I gotta admit, being a larger size model, I didn't really expect a whole lot, but wow. I kinda wonder if that design invokes a little something familiar, but let's not worry about that. Wow, that went pretty fast around the whole figure eight. Let's try this one more time. And that was a little too soft. So now let's try going somewhere in the middle. All right. That was nice. Third time's a charm there. Another 2023 model, Rolling Solo. This one I'm sure is going to make a good success on its first try. Its body design just speaks a lot. Oh, what did I tell you? First time, right off the bat. And the last car here is the 89 Mercedes-Benz 560 SEC AMG. Pretty long name, just rolls off the tongue right there. So, how does it do in this layout? Let's see. So that's pretty much it. 11 cars in total. They've all made it around the figure eight segment here. But this layout itself does have a secondary bit where it's just a typical oval shape. It goes into this nice little arc here, extremely banked, almost like an inversion, beyond inversions. But we're basically gonna use that as a method to see if any more can get through this whole layout in addition to the 11 that we've already done. So after a little cleanup here, considering the mess that's been made so far, let's get reset and back into action. And now, here we go. This is the second part of this layout. In action, basically. We're gonna go with the regular oval that goes through here and, well, into the cup, just the same as how we did with the first time. So, we're gonna breeze through these all at once. So, here we go. Thanks. Well, after a thing that's been said, done, and pretty much dealt with on all fronts, it seems that this upper portion is significantly harder than the figure eight, because I guess it might be the fact that the figure eight actually does hold a little less challenge as opposed to this bit. But you know what though? I'd say this was pretty darn fun to work with. And I guess at some other point in time, what we might try to do is integrate this into some more HWH material somewhere in the future. And with all these new cars I got, plus some old models that I have recollected officially as of today, I guess this concludes the epic marathon of unboxing and other such action relative to that. We'll be going back to regular scheduled HWH programming very soon. So I'll see you guys later on.